This is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Rudolf Spielmann and Karl Schlechter. This game was played in Vienna in 1914. Rudolf Spielmann had white pieces and he started with e4. Karl Schlechter played e5. Knight to c3, intending f4, the Vienna game. Knight to c6, f4, bishop to c5. White to move. F takes on e5 was played. The modern theory recommends knight to f3. F takes on e5 was played. White is intending d4 with a very strong center. Black to move. How would you continue in this position if you had black pieces? Karl Schlechter sacrificed the pawn. d6. If you don't like sacrificing the pawns, you can play bishop takes on g1. In the game we have d6, let's take it back. If knight takes on e5, then white wins with d4. Back to our game. So in this position Schlechter played d6. E takes on d6, queen takes on d6. Interesting strategy by black. White is a pawn up. But black already developed three of his pieces. The game continued. Knight to f3, bishop to g4. It is white to move. This position was never seen before. So Spielmann couldn't use a book knowledge to make a move. But he came up with an interesting idea. The idea is knight to e2, c3, d4. And pushing black off the board. So we have knight to e2. In the later years, white played bishop to b5 and d3 in this position. Spielmann played knight to e2. Schlechter castled the queenside. Very fast development by Schlechter. c3 and, like I said, intending d4 and pushing black off the board. White would have very strong center after d4 and black even has no e and d pawn. But for a compensation, black has a good activity of the pieces. Black to move, how would you continue? If black plays a quiet move like king to b8, then d4, and indeed, white is better. Schlechter played very logical move. f5, knight to f6 is also good. f5, intending to open the e-file. d4, it is now becoming very complex. What is the best square for the bishop? What would you do? If bishop goes to b6, then e5 and white is better. Schlechter played f takes on e4, attacking the knight. Knight to g5. D takes on c5 has a tiny downside, and that is queen takes on d1. So we have knight to g5, queen to e7, queen to c2, now threatening pawn takes bishop, maybe. Should black play bishop to d6 or bishop to b6? How would you continue? Well, there was a surprise. Schlechter played e3. Queen to e4. If d takes on c5, queen takes on g5. So e3 was cutting the communications between the bishop on c1 and the knight on g5. Queen to e4. Queen takes on g5. Bishop takes on e3, attacking the queen. And the next move could be pawn takes bishop on c5. Queen to h4, check. g3. Queen to h5. And finally, Spielmann captured the bishop. White is a pawn up. But the coordination of the white pieces is not so good. Black to move and to play the most logical move in this position. What would be the most logical move in this position? Very natural one. Knight to f6, developing the knight and attacking the queen. Queen to f4. Knight to d5, attacking the queen again. Queen to g5, offering to exchange queens. Should black accept the offer or not? Schlechter played knight takes on e3. If queen takes on g5, bishop takes on g5, and white king would feel much safer with queens off the board. Knight takes on e3 was played. Queen takes knight. If queen takes on h5, bishop takes on h5, black is better. Queen takes on e3. It is black to move. What would you do? Black played a move and white resigned. Believe it or not. And the move is rook from h to e8. Just a simple developing move. And Spielmann designed. One line goes like this. Let's say white wants to save the queen. And now in this position, black can play knight to e5 and also queen to d5. Both are winning. This is attacking the rook and threatening queen to d2, checkmate. If queen moves to f4, then knight to e5 and knight to d3 is deadly. That was an extremely sharp game, wasn't it? What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.